want virtually every aspect of our behaviour to be subject to the criminal law. Yesterday, the Deputy Chief Medical Officer and the Health Secretary set out updated advice for those who are shielding in England so that they can return to leading more normal lives. Opening up more of Britain in this COVID-secure way is only possible if everyone continues to stay alert to the risks of coronavirus. That means you should stay 2 metres apart. If you can't do that, then keep 1 metre apart with mitigations. Wash your hands regularly. Wear face coverings on public transport or where you're indoors in a crowded environment where distancing is not possible. Follow the rules when visiting businesses. Crucially, get a test done immediately if you develop symptoms, and self-isolate if you're asked to do so by NHS Test and Trace. We're only able to make these changes because we have persevered together and stuck to our path. We had 5 tests and we met them, we had a plan and we stuck to it. The government has asked a huge amount of all of you, and you met that challenge. The people of this country met that challenge with good humour and common sense. Of course, the fight is far from over. This is a nasty virus still that wants to take advantage of our carelessness. There will be, I'm afraid, there will be local outbreaks. And I must tell you that if the virus were to begin to run out of control, I will not hesitate to put on the handbrake and reverse some of these changes at local or indeed national level as required. But we can avoid that if we all continue to stay alert and do our bit to control the virus. The British public have proved again and again, not that it was ever in doubt, that they could be trusted to do the right thing and to do it with common sense. That there is no doubt we're beating back this virus. And with your continued cooperation and good judgment, we will beat it once and for all.
Good evening.